What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today we got the ThinkSystem SR650 V2 server. I got this special setup because this guy is actually housing two 1800 watt power supplies, and I had to hook them up into a big APC UPS system because I wasn't able to hook this guy into a regular house power outlet. And let's take a look over here. Yes, look at those two 1800 power supplies. I hooked them up into a special APC unit because it wasn't powering on. So I have everything hooked up. I got my laptop hooked up to my capture card so we could set this guy up. I got my camera over there with some lighting. We're gonna press the power button to turn it on. Yes, this guy has four 375 gig NVMe solid state drives. I think I said that correctly. All right, so today's video is all about configuring the ThinkSystem SR650 V2 with Proxmox. Hopefully I said that right. I'm probably killing the name, but I want to test this out with this particular machine. I have my flash drive right now. We need to download the ISO, which the ISO, you could basically just do a Google search for Proxmox. Make sure that you're clicking the correct link. It's not sponsored by anyone. You want to go into this link right here. It's going to redirect you to this website. You're going to click on downloads. And you can hear the machine right now going crazy. It just restarted itself. We want to download this guy right here. I already did that behind the scenes. Hopefully you guys can hear me, because the machine is just going crazy right now. I could just feel that power. Can you feel it? Can you hear it? Ah, awesome. I already have the ISO already downloaded, so I'm going to close this up right now. I'm going to open up Rufus. I'm going to insert our flash drive. Rufus located our flash drive. It is 64 gigs. I'm going to click on select, and I'm going to select our ISO, and the ISO is actually located here. Let me just double click on this, double click on this, go here, boom. Let's click on open. The image you have selected is a iOS hybrid. Okay, let's click OK. Let's click start. Gives us a nice little warning. It's going to wipe clean everything. We're going to click OK here. Our bootable drive is going to be created. Once that's done, we're going to plug it into our SR650 V2 server. Get inside the system setup, configure the boot manager, and get going. All right, so it rebooted a couple of times. The flash drive is ready. I am going to press F1. It highlighted blue. Awesome. It selected it. We're good to go. I got the flash drive right here. I am going to actually insert it into the back of the server because I'm actually using the USB mouse and the keyboard. On the front panel, there's two USB ports, one 2.0 and the other one is 3.2. I just glanced the system events. There's 0, 0, no warnings, no error. It just loaded into the X-Clarity Provisioning Manager. It calmed down a bit so it's not going crazy. I feel like I could... I'm going to go to the back and insert the USB. Perfect. Awesome. Now, in the past, I drove myself kind of crazy, and a lot of you guys left comments saying, just press F12. Yes, I'm going to press F12, but I want to do a couple of things in here before we continue. I want to go inside System Summary, and I want to check a couple of things out. Now, this server is running an Intel Xeon Silver 4314 CPU with a base speed of 2.40 gigahertz. It's two of them. We got two processors. What? That is crazy. We have 512 gigs of memory. All 32 DIMM slots are filled up. Each memory stick is around 16 gigs. Holy crap, that is awesome. 349 gigs. NVMe solid state drives. There's a good chance. Let's go to RAID setup. No supported RAID adapter found. Please check. Okay. That means the first disk, I could probably install the operating system. And then this 1, 2, and 3 I could use them as virtual machine storage. I can't do a RAID setup here. Okay. So let's go inside the UEFI setup. Let's go to Boot Manager. Let's add a generic boot option. Let's click on USB storage. Excellent. Let's click on save. Let's click yes here. Oh, there it goes. Got to click it again one more time. Saving, excellent. Let's go back. And if I want, I could change the boot order. I could change the boot order, but it really doesn't matter because I'm going to listen to you guys and I'm going to press F12. So let's go over here, exit out of here. We're going to click OK. All right, so we got the option. Let's press F12. It highlighted it blue. Awesome. We're going to do a one-time boot device. All right, here it goes. The boot device manager has finally loaded up. We only have one option, which is this guy right here, which is our SanDisk. We're going to highlight that. We're going to hit enter. Cross the fingers. It should load up the Proxmox. Yes. Welcome to Proxmox virtual environment. We are going to pick the first one. We're going to install it using the graphical interface. Let's hit enter here. It's going to start the process. All right, we just got the license agreements. I guess I have to scroll all the way down. And on the lower right-hand side, let's click on I agree. Beautiful. I cannot see. I am blind right now. Okay. Click on the drop down. All right, so these are the four hard drives. I'm going to select the very first one, which should be the one on zero. You got 0, 1, 2, and 3, which is 4. We're going to click on next. It wants you to give a country US, time zone. Let's find our time zone. Here it goes. Found it. Finally found it. America, New York, US, English for the keyboard layout. Let's click next. Please select a country first. Oh, okay. United States. There's a drop down. I can't see, but there was actually a drop down there. And let's click next now. A password. Let's give it a password. I hit the tab key. We're going to confirm the password. Make sure that you remember the password. And let's give it an email address. Email address would be itsupport@btnhd.edu. Let's hit next here. Let's give it a host name, an IP address, a gateway, a DNS. For the host name, let's give it PB, right? PBE. .btnhd.edu. For the IP address, I'm going to give it 10.10.10.10. Default gateway is going to be 10.10.10.1. DNS, I don't need a DNS, but I can leave it as is. I am going to hit next here. You get a nice little summary. This is the IP address for the new server. Underneath the summary, by default, it has automatically reboot after the success of the installation. We want that. Let's click on install. Now it is creating the partitions. Once the partitions is created, it's going to start installing the operating system into that partition and then hopefully install Proxmox properly and then reboot. All right, so the installation completed on the ThinkSystem SR650 B2. This guy is a beast, but I have bad news, and I did a noob mistake, so let's head in the back, and I will explain. All right, so we are at the back of the SR650 V2, and I did a noob mistake, and I inserted the RJ45 into the X-Clarity management port. That's a big no-no. This is only for managing it. That's it. There's no other RJ45 at the back. Lenovo did hook us up with a SFP module, but this is fiber, and I don't have a switch to set this up and continue the installation. So hard stop right here. sad day for us, but it is okay. Hopefully I will pick up a fiber switch with Ethernet and all that stuff. So when one of these machines come in, I could do the setup for you guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.